वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। वी हैव टू डिस्कस थ्री चैप्टर्स, ऑलमोस्ट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एंड वी हैव टू डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस मूविंग चार्जेस मैग्नेटिज्म। We have to discuss how a field is to be created by a current carrying wire. In the previous lecture, we have discussed. This is a current carrying wire. If the charged particle is thrown like that, it gets deviated from its path. We have to see in the previous lectures. It means we have to construct simple construction is that a current carrying wire produces a magnetic field that is we know very well. And a new type of field, that field is to be known as magnetic field. Magnetic field. The name of the new field is magnetic field, and it is represented by the symbols. That symbols is used for the magnetic field is E. And now magnetic field is in is in. This is the most important aspects that a magnetic field is a vector quantity. If magnetic field is a vector quantity, the difficulties will be arise here, because if this quantity is a scalar, then the addition of scalar quantities is very simpler in all the way. But if this quantity is to be vector, then we have to maintain the direction when we are add up of the two quantities. If the both of the quantities have the same direction, then it will be add up, otherwise it cannot be add up. These are the basic disadvantages of the vector quantities. And if the quantities are to be in a scalar form, then they are simply added and simple addition has to be taken place. If the quantities are the vector quantities, these quantities cannot be add up at the simple manners. The first we have to add up by the directions. We have to see the direction. We have to improve the directions. How the directions is to be, both of the directions can be taken place. Both of the physical quantities, how that in the same directions or otherwise in opposite directions. So we have to first focus on which direction that is to be taken place. So we have to do this. This is the vector quantities. Now, SI unit of magnetic field. SI unit of magnetic field. The SI unit of magnetic field is to be Tesla. Nikola Tesla, the scientist. On the name of the scientist, which takes 100 and more years the working of the magnetic field. So we have to take a simple way of the magnetism, that is Tesla, and simply represented as this is the SI unit. And the next SI unit we have to see that B1 upon meters. This is also the unit of Weber upon meter square. This is also the unit of magnetic field. This is used, otherwise this is used. The third unit of the magnetic field is to be Gauss. This is also the unit of magnetic field. And the conversion factor that is to be taken here, 1 Tesla is equal to 10 to the power 4 Gauss. 1 Tesla is equal to 10 to the power 4 Gauss. And this is simply represented by capital G. Our earth is also act as a magnet. And the earth magnetism is so weak that can write approximately that can create a own magnetic field by the earth is. This is approximately 10 to the power minus 5 Gauss. This is the magnetic field that is created by the earth. On the earth surfaces, it is the creation of the magnetic field that is very smaller in quantities. And this is to be right 10 to the power minus 5 Gauss. This is very weak magnetic field because of earth creation. Because our earth creates various types of dangerous flares, various types of radiations that is to be coming on the earth that are deviated by the effect of magnetic field. If there is a no magnetic field, we cannot survive like that. There are various types of diseases that is to be occurring in our surroundings. Because if the various types of charge particles that is appears to be comes on the earth surfaces, the earth magnetism deviates its path, and or if the path is to be deviated that cannot reach on the earth, then we will survive easily. If this factors